Okay, so we have the artboard ready with a size of 400 by 300 millimeter. First of all, I will click on the ellipse tool to create a circle. Size is 300 by 300 millimeter. Align it in the center of the artboard. Then I will use the zigzag effect to make some changes to the circle. You can just explore the settings here. I think 16 actually will be too many, but I will just go with that one for now. Expand appearance. Then I will need to click on copy and Control C and Control F to copy and paste it in the front and reduce the size to very tiny on the middle, and then blend and make. And then Control A to select it all, and then Effect Pathfinder and Exclude. Then you still have all selected, Control A, and double click on the Blend tool and set the blend options as you like. Okay, then you can double click on the middle circle, so you will be able to rotate the middle circle. Transform and rotate. I will just try different angles here, which one I like the most, or which one worked the most with this. Yeah, I will stick with that one. Oh, maybe no. I like this one though. Okay, I will move the little circle from the middle to somewhere on the bottom right. So when I will enlarge the image, it will look good on the whole artboard. That will be fine there. Okay, once I'm ready, just go back from editing mode. Yeah. And I can finally enlarge the image to cover the whole artboard. No, but before that, I had to expand the appearance, yeah. I like it like that. Then I will need to create a rectangle to cover the artboard the same size, 400 by 300 millimeter. Align it in the center, horizontally and vertically, Control A to select it all, and then Pathfinder and crop, and here we are. It looks good already. But I also wanted to add some frame to this, so I will use the rectangle tool again for that one. Yes, I like it. Okay, so for the frame, rectangle tool, the same size, 400 by 300. Align it in the middle. Come on. Okay, 400 by 300, align it in the middle, and then I will swap the swatches around, yeah. So, stroke, no fill, and I will increase the stroke to, let's say, 25. And I will need to expand the appearance of the stroke. And that will be the final result. I like it. I like it a lot. I hope you like it too. Thank you for watching.